Conley. Good on the baseline, Jay. Well, talking about Parker and the bigs, Tony benefited from their presence, Clark, but they also benefited from his play.
Really, early in their careers, the only way to defend Parker and Duncan was to pack the lane, and once Tony developed a consistent jump shot, the only way to defend them was to hope and pray.
Right. Now, here's Stevenson, following the miss by LaMarcus Aldridge. It's rebounded by Aldridge.
I'm a fan of anybody who defends that way. I mean, they weren't about to open the door and just allow him to cruise in for a layup.
Now here's Parker. He has five. Such a wide open look.
And if you're the guy who has to guard him, it is never going to be an easy night for you.
Conley kicks to Carter. Outside Gasol. Stevenson outside. Out to Carter. Let's it go with a three. Can't get it to go. Now San Antonio takes it the other way. They come in fresh off a win against the Heat.
They just weren't challenged. I mean, nearly as much as they should have been in that game, at least when they had the ball.
Yeah, it was a mismatch. I mean, the defense from the start was on its heels practically the entire game. Very nice pickup of the offensive rebound. And once he gets his hands on it, you know it's going back up and back in.
Now here is Carter. Boy, he was something else against the Lakers. Gasol drives in. It's hauled in by LaMarcus Aldridge. San Antonio leading by four. Parker with it. Now guarded by Stevenson. Gasol against Aldridge. And Leonard has it in the corner. Aldridge with a screen on Randolph. Nobody near Leonard. Mike Conley grabs the miss.
When he's wide open like that, he'll rarely miss those.
He kicks it to Gasol. Hits some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good.
Well, he knew how many inches he had over the guy. I mean, let's face it, good decision to just rise up and take the jump shot.
Rejected by Gasol. Carter outside. That's good, and it's Stevenson with the assist. Carter's got five.
Well, that fast break went according to plan.
Yeah, nice job there, Greg. Recognizing the opportunity was there to push it, and then excellent execution.
And here's Leonard from three. Once again off the mark by San Antonio. The Grizzlies have gone 4-7 from the field, shooting over 50%. Right side, Conley. To the middle. Here's Gasol, and that one hits back iron.
That's a huge part of what they want to do defensively, limit his easy chances inside.
Well, the Spurs just don't go on losing streaks very often, Greg. One perk of being a talented veteran group.
Yeah, how about the Spurs lost four games in a row twice last year. Over the last decade before that, Kevin, they had only lost four games in a row twice. Unbelievable.
And here's Carter following the three-pointer by Tony Parker. Here's Randolph. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
If you're waiting for him to miss when he's that open, you're going to be in for a long wait.
Parker against Conley. Parker dishes to Leonard. Good D by Gasol.
Boy, I tell you what, guys, he's an extremely strong finisher. I'm surprised he wasn't able to power that through the defense.
Green against Stevenson. Inside, Gasol. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. The Grizzlies shooting their first shots of the night from the charity stripe.
Yeah, pretty good numbers on the season when you look at their free throw attempts, right around 78%.
Those are good numbers for any team. I mean, they can feel extremely good about their free throw shooting percentage this season.
Ties it up. He's off on the second.
They should be in front right now, but he'll be relieved not to have come up totally empty there.
40 seconds left in the first quarter. The pass to Mills. And again, it's San Antonio with a three.
How in the world did they let him get that wide open?
Last outing for Memphis, they won that game against the Los Angeles Lakers.
And they may have been on the road, but you know what? They nullified any home court disadvantage in that game by how well they shot it from three.
Shooting can always be a great equalizer. I mean, when you shoot like that from outside, it really makes winning on the road a lot easier.
Here's Marjanovic. He's guarded by Stevenson. That drops.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Beyond the arc. And the release was before the buzzer, but it's off target. And that does it for the first quarter. It's the Spurs leading by five. And we'll be back in just a moment with the start of the second quarter. Marcus Aldridge, the franchise player on this team, without question. He talked about the responsibility that comes with that role.
In every aspect, you know, it's a change for us, being more vocal, doing it on the court, trying to lead in practice. I think overall everything I do has to be better because guys are trying to follow me.
Greg, does that acceptance come with putting a whole lot more pressure on yourself? And if so, what does that do to LaMarcus Aldridge's game?
And, you know, Kevin, that's what's going to be so interesting to find out. Now, some players, you know, they really relish in that situation. They rise to that occasion. Others, I don't want to say they wilt under the pressure, but they're just not comfortable in that environment. And in the NBA, you get to do it on TV and in front of thousands in person.
And we return to the second quarter, and Noche Latina, specialized jerseys on display. Welcome back, everyone. All right, well, a look at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for the Spurs.
Well, I tell you what, they must have had a good shoot-around because they've been fantastic from long range so far, fellas.
Also, guys, the passing has been terrific in the first half. They'll be happy with all those assists.
And a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. On the floor for San Antonio, Mills and Manu at the guards. West is out there with Boris Diaw. Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, what do you have?
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Lakers stepped up to deliver. He picked up 5 points, and along with what he did on the offensive end, he also played some stellar defense as well. This was just the game he wanted to have as he leads his team to the playoffs. You want to be hot late, Kevin.
All right, thanks, Doris. He's got a lot of positives to take away from that game.
He really does. It was one of his better performances, and that's saying something because we've seen this guy have a lot of good ones.
And you'd have to imagine that he'll be out to build on it, to go one better here tonight.
Here's Ginobili. It's good. The assist that time from Dion. Ginobili's got his first bucket of the night.
And that's the kind of lead pass we've come to expect from him.
And you really got to admire Boris Diaw. I mean, he's found a way to kind of reform his game as he's gotten older. I mean, so different than when he was new to the league.
Now Mills, following the three-point attempt by Freak.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Baseline Jay on the way. No good. And San Antonio will go the other way with it. Diaw lost his athleticism and is a slower player than before. You could argue he's more productive now, though, Clark, than ever.
Well, his game was always on the ground in my mind. He's highly skilled. He's much more cerebral on the floor than given credit. I mean, I think he is really a difficult matchup because he's crafty, he's tough, and he's experienced and skilled.
Now, here's Mills. He's guarded closely. Kicks to Diaw. Trying to find Mills. Gets it to him. Good! Mills has got the lead up to 9 now for the Spurs.
That mid-range jumper is just another one of his weapons.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
They got to find some, you're right. There's the pick. Freak passes to Anderson. Freak kicks to Stevenson. Memphis needs to get off a shot here. Here's Moreno. Solid defense there from Ginobili. Spurs leading by nine. He dishes it to Mills. Jacks up a three. Offensive rebound, and he slams it one-handed.
And great effort on the boards, and what a mean.
Yeah.
That was, Gary. I mean, you just will not see him ever quit on a play.
That guy is a handful. You've got to have a body on him, Clark, at all times.
And you know what? Sometimes that's not even enough. He'll go around, over, or through you to get to the pumpkin.
Spurs with some changes. Marcus Aldridge has checked in for West. Green comes in for Boris Diaw. And Parker subbed in for Patty Mills. Memphis also making some changes. Zach Randolph's checked in for Jamichael Green. Carter comes in for Lance Stevenson. And it's Mike Conley in for Freak. Now here is Carter. He has five. Pass to Allen. Conley against Parker. Here's the screen. Carter inside the three-point line. In the hoop for his third make from the field. He's 3-for-4 thus far in the contest. Spurs leading by nine. Green, and he finishes nicely on the layup.
Four of their last five makes came off of a high-quality shot inside.
Textbook, really, when you look at how they're playing. They are having their way down low.
Now here is Conley. Another key contributor to that nice win against the Lakers. Dishes to Carter. He feeds it to Conley. Carter sets the pick for Conley. Picked by Randolph. Goes up on the high post. Anderson dishes to Randolph. The basket drops and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Really aggressive play there, taking it to the rack against the big fella.
You know, Greg, aggressiveness is really the only option when you're on the wrong side of the size equation.
In a league that's becoming more and more pick-and-roll oriented, Zach Randolph is more of a throwback, if you will. I mean, he likes to back his man down and battle for those offensive rebounds.
Duncan, he's checked in for San Antonio. Leonard comes in for Manu Ginobili. Free throw good, Randolph. Oh, I love the power forward. Zach Randolph always seems to carve out space, the space he needs to play well.
Yeah, he's unorthodox, but extremely gifted. A nice blend of physicality with high skill level, especially when you talk about shooting the ball.
The Grizzlies trail by eight. Conley kicks to Carter. Outside Conley. Allen passes to Gasol. And again, Memphis no good. San Antonio's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. The drive by Green. Aldridge a screen. Here's Parker. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in. Parker's got 10 points in the game.
Another gap in the defense found there, and they've really had their number today.
Kick by Randolph. Allen dishes to Conley. Randolph, a screen on Leonard. Conley gets to Gasol. Unloads from 13. That's in there. Conley with the assist. Conley's got three assists tonight. Parker with it. He picked up 12 points in their last win against Miami. And the rebound goes to the Grizzlies. 58 seconds left in the second quarter. Vince Carter on the wing. Back to Conley. Randolph kicks to Carter. Randolph a screen. Duncan against Carter. Green with the rebound. Spurs leading by 8. All alone. And he nails the jumper. Green's got 4 points in the quarter. We've got 28 seconds left here in the second. Outside Conley. He kicks to Gasol. Count that one.
And not a great start for him in the first, but he's quickly starting to turn it around.
For San Antonio, they've gone 6 of 11 from the floor. Over 50% shooting here in the second quarter. Parker passes to Aldridge. Gasol with the steal. Outside Conley. And the first half is now in the books. Spurs lead by 8. And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Well, David, a great first half that demonstrates a lot of the evolution of this team. As a veteran of this group, can you tell us a bit about the concepts that have helped this cohesion?
You know, we've developed some good habits, creating an identity. But we've just got to continue to try to make the right play every single time. And then the game will speak for itself.
David, thank you. Guys, coach would point directly to this guy as to what this team is all about.
Thank you for the great interview, Doris. We'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
Okay, everybody, pay attention. We definitely got some stuff to go over from the first half. We're not going to let this game get away from us.
Firstly, our offensive output in the paint was really encouraging. But that being said, let's make sure we don't get too one-dimensional in the second half. I want us getting points from the inside and out. Ball security was probably our high point. Let's continue to keep a tight handle on the ball and not try to thread too many needles with our passes. And don't worry too much about our tempo this half. We'll take what the defense gives us, whether it's on the break or on the half-court set.
We've got an uphill battle on our hands, no doubt about it. I don't want to catch you guys looking at the scoreboard. All we can do is play our game.
All right, the second half beginning in just a moment. It's been a clinic from Tony Parker.
You know, we talk so often about making your teammates better, and his ability to see the floor and then make those passes on time in that first half was the key.
Boy, I tell you what, they say he's not a playmaker, but he certainly has fooled me with the way he's performing right now.
So the Grizzlies 5 right now. Randolph is the 4 with Gasol in the middle. And Stevenson is out there with Conley. And it's Carter in at the small forward. Some solid numbers once again for Zach Randolph with Memphis last year. He just keeps plugging away, grinding out, no pun intended, chugging along and producing.
Yeah, 16 points, about 10 and a half rebounds for Z-Bo. I mean, he's a classic power forward and always gives you the numbers, even though he still plays under the rim.
Aldridge misses. The Grizzlies trail by 8.
Got it. Get the ball inside.
Now, here's Stevenson. Outside Gasol. Here's the 3. Conley's shot is off. San Antonio's gone 3-7 tonight from three-point territory. Parker dishes to Green. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Parker. Green's got the lead up to 11 now for the Spurs. Conley kicks to Carter. Randolph against Aldridge. And it's Randolph penetrating, so he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up, and 2 shots coming up. And, of course, Tony Parker. And the Grizzlies with some changes. Wright comes in for Zach Randolph. And Freak subbed in for Carter. Conley against Parker. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Aldridge has got his second basket of the night.
And, you know, getting back to Popovich's relationship with Tony Parker, Pop made the decision to draft Parker. So he obviously saw something. But Pop's a perfectionist, and if you're going to play point guard for him, you've got to deliver consistently.
Now here's Freak. Good-looking screen by Gasol. And another miss by Memphis.
That's one for their first four to start the second half.
Feeds it to Aldridge. That doesn't go either for Aldridge.
And talking about Tony Parker, Pop's tough love with him really paid off. Tony eventually became incredibly consistent, culminating with him being named the Finals MVP back in 07.
And here is Parker, following the three-pointer by Lance Stevenson. It's Ginobili on the wing. There's a screen. Down low, off the pick, and he comes off the screen and slams it through.
You always hear about chemistry. That's a perfect example, knowing where each other is at all times.
Stevenson outside. At the elbow, it's Freak. From 13, shot is off. Solid defense there from Ginobili.
With the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be. Firmly in control of this game.
And no doubt about it, rebounding is an effort stat, folks. They've been more determined than their opponent thus far.
Another pass put right into the shooter's pocket, right in the shooting pocket, for a terrific assist. They've done a lot of that today.
And it's something we haven't seen much of at the opposite end of the floor.
That one's good. The San Antonio lead has cut down to just 10 points on the bucket for Moreno. San Antonio's gone 5-9 when they put up the three-point shot tonight. Here's Marjanovic. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
And one thing that everybody loves about Coach Pop is his frankness. You get a taste of it in interviews, but he's as honest and straightforward with you as he is with anybody else.
Well, you've got Greg Popovich, and I think he puts this at times grumpy demeanor in more of a spotlight. He's playing along, as we all know, with the sideline reporters. He knows, Greg, you know this firsthand, when to turn it on, when to turn it off. He can be as compassionate a person, Clark, that you and I have ever been around.
Yeah, he's competitive, but he understands that we're all human, and he treats people the right way all the time.
And that one goes in, two from the line that time. The Grizzlies trail by 12. Now Conley. He's been playing a big part of their offensive scheme, averaging around 15.5 points a game.
And bullseye with that assist. Nice delivery there in traffic.
The Spurs have gotten 5 of 8 shots to fall for them in the third quarter. A nice 62% from the field. We've got 1:48 left to play in the third. Mills passes to West. It's rebounded by Memphis. Here's Moreno. And the rejection by Leonard. And the whistle blew, so that'll be a shooting foul. Great defensive effort there with the blocked shot. But he got more than just the ball that time. Free throws coming up right now. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for the Spurs.
Boy, their passing has been picturesque. A thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
And also, I think it's really led to the rhythm and confidence you've seen from long range tonight throughout the entire game.
Boris Diaz checked in for San Antonio. Both shots good from the stripe.
This is as good as it gets from the charity stripe here in the second.
Yeah, you know what? And I think they've just got to keep on keeping on. Keep drawing contact, attacking, getting to the line. That will certainly give them a chance to get back into the game. They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
We got to be more physical on defense. On the interior. They are getting to the middle of the floor way too easy. Get into them on the perimeter. Posts. Rotate over and make your presence felt. Quit being so soft.
Grizzlies making a switch here. Carter's checked in. The Grizzlies trail by 10. And so it's San Antonio who scraped by with the win. It was a fantastic ball game, and they did a great job making sure it didn't get away from them late.
Yeah, and they got pushed down the stretch, but they did what they needed to do and held their ground when it mattered most and got the W.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
David, what is it you like about the way this team is playing right now?
You know, we're just defending. I think we're playing together, making extra pass. Every NBA game is a different challenge, so again, we just got to come ready to compete. You know, guys are taking pride in their preparation.
David, thank you as always. Guys, what a culture they've established here.
All right, Doris, thank you. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. And now to our good friend Ernie Johnson, who is standing by in the studio.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Ernie Johnson here again with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. Without further ado, let's present to you our Jordan player of the game, Tony Parker. Kenny, what did you like about his game?
He was dead on from the field tonight, guys. I'd call his performance economical because there was no wasted opportunities. He took advantage of every good look he got. I mean, everything he put up was going in.
Tony Parker is putting on a show. The Sabone Assassin does it again. Man, see, he started out as a traditional one guard, bringing the ball up, getting to the back filler. But now, the team, it leans on him.
And that'll do it for tonight. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our illustrious 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson. Have a good night, everybody.
Yeah, send him in. Cece.
Hey, how are you?
Good to see you again.
My pleasure.
Freak, great game last night.
That's what I do, right?
Indeed, have a seat. Pagnotti.
How you doing?
Thought you'd be selling used cars by now.
Funny, comedian. I thought you would have invested in some new clothes, being a team owner and all. I see you still rocking that Goodwill look.
Freak, what are you hanging around with this guy for? You know he's bad company, right?
Got no choice. He helps me pay the bills. Plus, our mother loves him.
Thank you all for coming by on such short notice.
You're welcome.
So you know why we're here, right?
Not really.
You want to negotiate an extension for Freak, right?
Well, since you mentioned it, your client is quickly becoming a liability for this organization.
We've already put a plan in place that's going to address all your concerns and issues.
Let me finish. Thank you. Myself, the front office, and the coaches are not satisfied with the adjustments you've made in your life off the court. I personally warned you about the company you keep, and we're fed up with the late nights and showing up late to shoot arounds and the bad press and the incident at the nightclub. I told you Vic was going to be your downfall, and I was right. Something has to change now, or we're not going to need your services any longer.
If this is about that Twitter stuff, Vic was playing. Okay, it was a joke.
It's not about that. It's everything.
But like I told you before, Vic is my best friend. I can't just cut him off. He's practically family.
Not really.
What exactly are you trying to say?
I'm not trying to say anything, Dom. I'm saying it. Freak and his friend Vic are a problem for me and this organization. And I called you in here to figure out how we all together can fix this problem. And right now, I'm only seeing one solution.
I agree that Freak may need to make some adjustments in his personal life off the court, but that's a learning process. We both know that. But this almost sounds like a threat. And Dom Pagnotti doesn't take too kindly to threats. Is this a threat?
Call it what you will.
We all know that Vic is a problem. The only person who doesn't seem to realize that is my brother. I'm sorry, bro, but enough is enough.
I don't have a problem with what you're saying. I have a problem with how you're saying it. Now, I know we can come to some understanding without all the ultimatums or threats.
Can we all come to a understanding, a compromise?
No, no more compromises. I already warned Freak. I told you, don't be a hero. Cut that zero. It's cut Vic loose or we trade Freak. It's that simple.
Fine, we'll go sign with another team.
Good luck with that, Pagnotti. Because of Vic, Freak's reputation precedes him.
No, because of Freak's God-given talent, his reputation precedes him.
Everybody's been talking. Dom, you know how this works. This is not about you and me and our history. This is about your client. Help him.
You're talking as if I'm invisible. You're talking around me, about me, but not to me. Vic has always had my back. And I've given this team everything I got. I practice hard. I play hard. Yeah, some nights I got it, some nights I don't. Some days I might even show up a little late to shoot arounds. But every time I'm on that call, I've always given my best. And I see how it is, though. I mean, us players got to be loyal to you, but you don't have to be loyal to us players. Try to give me some father and son talk, talking about how you love your players and how you look up for them. Come on, man. You trying to cut me off like you cut off Izzy. Don't you have people loyal to you no matter what? People you can't cut off? Well, that's me and Vic. Vic and me. Y'all insist, really. They could tell me stop hanging with Vic. What makes you think they won't tell me stop talking to you? You remember in seventh grade, some guys were trying to jump me over some girl. Vic was the one to get some friends just to walk me home. And when they came, we went at it, but I wasn't alone. When I got my scholarship, it was Vic who put the word on the streets that nobody should mess with me because I had a future. Vic was protecting me. And sir, I know Vic is crazy. But before all the hype and the lights, media, fans, it was just me and Vic. He's always been there. I mean, if y'all don't like that, I don't know what to say.
It hurts me to say this, but I see his point. What you don't understand is that the league doesn't have your back anymore. Not like they used to. They try, but it's too much. Social media has changed everything. And this last incident with Vic, that was the final straw.
It was a joke.
It wasn't funny. You know it wasn't a joke. Vic was defending you, stepping in to protect your honor by attacking another teammate like that? Talking about his manhood, his wife, his kids, his family, so you can be the big dog on the court? What's on call for?
And they all know your relationship with Vic, so they think it's coming from you.
But that's the media blowing everything out of proportion, as usual.
It's not just the media. He's attacking other players, other teams. He's out of control. Vic just doesn't know how to behave.
We got guys on our squad who don't want to be here because of that beef. There is no place for that kind of inappropriate behavior in this league. If you can't trust your teammates, who can you trust?
What Vic is doing isn't right. He's bringing you down, and people can see it. I see how all the other players are looking at you. Oh, it's not cool. It's not cool at all.
What, don't talk to him? Don't hang with him?
You do what you gotta do. That's your call. But let me tell you this. You asked me if I had friends that I couldn't cut off. Yeah, I did for a while. Friends, business partners, girlfriends, wives, family that I thought I couldn't cut off. But I learned that sometimes you gotta make the hard decisions. I mean, some of these people, they were just bad for me. They were bringing me down. They weren't making me better. They were good for the time that they were there, but I grew up, not in age and maturity, but in mind and spirit. I was ready for the next level in my life. And I'll be honest with you, I've been on the receiving end of that. I've been cut off before myself, and yeah, it hurt at the time, but looking back, they were doing the right thing for me. Just don't tell my ex-wife that, Pagnotti.
So what's the next move?
The next move is Freaks. It always has been. Question is he ready and willing to do what needs to be done?
This is messed up.
You take a moment to think about it, but think long, think wrong. The snafu should have been cleaned up a long time ago. With or without you, we got games to win.
Freak, you gotta handle your business.
Okay, we've all said our piece. You might cut me off as your manager, but I will always be your sister. So when this is on you, I might not like it, but I will respect any decision you make. Yvette, please.
Cece.
Yvette.
Where's Dom?
I had him call you.
Why?
I'm gonna cut right to the chase. My brother is deeply in love with you. And I'm ready to put our differences aside if you are.
Really?
On a string.
I'm with it.
Team Freak.
Team Freak.
All right, so if you're gonna be down with the team, I gotta show you the dap.
The dap?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, like this.
Oh.
One, two, three. Shoot. Swish.
Swish.
Yeah. Again.
Like,
mm-hmm.
Oh. Okay. One, two, three, swish.
Yeah.
Okay. Like that.
Cool, right?
Yeah.
Take them back.
Yeah.